Okay, so back on the resource, back on the image train, I've rebuilt a quick faux image resource. It's just bog standard with, in this case, because I don't actually have a faux graphics image type yet. It's still just Vulkan image, these functions right now, which return raw stuff. I need to. So the basic image is there, the basic pool is there, which is, well, super basic. I just need to do the loader. And I already had this in the branch, which I have off on the side here. The image branch. So I'm just going to mostly work off of that, put it in the new form, because I can't merge or rebase directly. It's been a little bit too much of a difference. So where am I on image loader? Fun stuff. I have the graphic session, the upload context I need to create locally, and otherwise bog standard stuff down here. Yes, sirree. Okay. So we'll go to. Where is it? Really? This. We need these three functions. Get rid of that, get rid of that. Turn and graphics session. That. Loader. What we got initialized, error code stuff. Then we have the error stuff at the end. So we got that with the M graphic session, which will equal the session that we give it. Error code will equal faux graphics. Create upload context, which takes in the session. The upload context, we create it. If error code, then go to initialization failed. Simple enough. The initialization is pretty much the same thing, but we have to if. We need to delete it or destroy it. And there's no way to actually clear that out yet, right? Don't think so. Interloader, that gives us processing of unload requests. Now, in this old one, what did I have? I have, it's part of the image instead. Okay. How do I unload it? Or do I just not care about it? I don't think I even care about it. I just bothered with loading it and that was it. Out of the creation of the error image. Or this. Okay. Some new code. We'll mostly. What's this? This is the same. We have to do is on the unload requests, have a different data struct. And we have this. We need to go through. There's no sub resources for images, it's just it. So we got. Destroy sampler, which... Huh. Oh, yeah, not great. Get the device. Get device from the session. Okay. We'll use that. Data.sampler. We don't even touch the allocator yet. Doubtful I will. This also does mean I'm going to have to go through and abstract away images after this. You get allocator from the graphic session. Again, another one of these temporary types. All right. So that'll just mean I need the request. Okay. The load request load. The putting onto the unload. Same deal, all that stuff. Okay. Now, going back to image, there was the use of a base type to switch between an error image and a image file. Going to have to think about this one a little bit. But, for the moment, if it's always loading from a file, from the YAML file at least. And the YAML file specify if it's an error image or a different type right now. Yeah. Okay, so at the moment, first things first, what I need to do is go enter loading state. Loading process. This stuff which will import image data. Okay. Don't really want to save that in the application. But we do, okay. Gonna need some, okay, we're gonna have to delve into the YAML stuff again. Now this has, IMX image. This which doesn't even work on Windows yet. Okay, what we can do first of all is export. I think. Actually, how would I even export this? Because I don't even have most of that information in memory, unless it's in for the editor stuff. Cute. I don't even know how to fully export this yet. So I will focus on importing it first. Now, I already do have two. What was it? So for the moment, we'll just focus on string for the file name. That's it. We're just focusing on the file name. And that's it. We'll get everything else from that later, I think. Maybe. For the moment, yes. And then from that, we'll focus on how we can export it as well. So YAML, Going to the YAML side, this doesn't even exist because it's all source-based now. That's what we want. Wanna end that. Yeah, okay. Open the YAML file. This stuff, this template stuff. YAML log. Okay, we'll assume we're kind of okay up to that point. We'll finish the rest of the YAML in a moment. No, I'll actually kind of finish it right now. I'm not going to put this off. YAML read image definition. So we got the root node, we got the file name. That's kind of it for the moment. No subtype yet around here. Sorry. There we are. Why do I even? I don't think I even need this stuff really. need the whole thing, please. I need to move it over here. Then I need to go to this. How do we read the stuff? We first of all do this boilerplate here. Try catch stuff. Resources, graphics, data, then other data, I guess. Right now, I only have other data, so. Equals subnode of. Actually, you know what? No. YAML read required. Right now it'll be node name file. It's going to be on subnode. And it'll be the file name. Standard string. Bam. Simple enough. PNG, we come back out with the file name. Okay, come back out here, we're image loader, we have this, we have the file name. So come back out to the loader. If not red, then we go to loading failed. Let's get the loading failed stuff out of the way here. Gotta do pimage. Image this. There's no loading data. Don't have any of this stuff yet. So now that, okay, now that we're at image, and the same thing would also have to happen with models and meshes, is I'm going to have to start bringing in metadata, at least on the editor versions of these. The rest of the, like, because for fragment descriptors and samplers and stuff, I could always, or could I? I don't think I could, actually. That's true. Or was it? Because for the shader and the shader 2, no, I already have the spur V source as part of that. I can't re-export that, can I? going on a tangent here, but I really need to write the shader definitions per vSource equal. Yeah, so right now, writing this for. Oh my god. Ah!
It's hard coded still. It's still hard coded. Okay.
Of course, this is also one of the types which has a delayed upload cycle from. Yeah. Which makes this even harder. So, okay. So, image. Okay. Image loader is going to have like a two-stage loading mechanism. It can't be just one, because I'm not just creating it and being done. I have to start the process of uploading it. I start the process of loading it. I get the data in, and I have to send it to be uploaded. Then I have to I have to take the data that's being uploaded. Once it's done, then I need to stick it in here. So this can't even be here anyways. I mean, it could maybe. So this would actually mean I'd probably want to bring back the process load requests kind of thing. Now for most of them they'll be empty, but for this will be like a real thing. And this wouldn't even, like, this would only happen if it's a load that failed. Otherwise, we're going to have to. So this will be like part of a secondary stage. Quite yet. inside the unload sync. I'm gonna need like a load sync. But what data am I bringing with me? It will be the faux image data plus the upload data, which is what? What was the request? It's like the upload request. So. Not quite that. Would it be even an array? It's just we can just do it as a vector and swap them out. Yeah. Upload request. That's that, and then we have the this data. Be blank for the moment. And I'd also need like the original image that it's for, of course. Put that at the start. Call an upload request. Process uploaded resource. Start resource. Upload. So that's what we do when we enter. And here we'll start the upload resource. It goes in, it does this, it loads the information from the file asynchronously. It'll load the image data, then it'll start the process of then we'll upload. Clear all relevant data. Processed by this other. Okay. where dot pimage equals pimage. We have dot upload request equals. Which I don't have yet, and dot data equals this dot sampler equals sampler. The image photo will be going like, it'll be part of this really. Upload request. Actually, you know what? No. Graphics upload request. Be more specific, yes. Okay, rather image just blank. Just pass that in. Okay, that'll be a bit easier. What I can probably also do is image loader. And instead of taking these, we'll take in these individually. Click that, it'll take this. And then I'll take this. Copy these in on the stack. Because these won't be too much. So that I have a copy for ownership purposes. So what I do instead is, okay, process upload request with p image graphics upload request, this. What can happen then inside of this function is that it'll check on the request basically right away. So that maybe we can also swap it out immediately. Check the status of the request. Upload request status from upload request while it's not a while loop, we're just checking it. If it's done, we're going to continue. Otherwise, swap the data in, else if request status not equal for graphics upload status request incomplete, that means there was an error of some sort. Otherwise, else, it's not yet complete. Add to the uploading data list. And this is what, then we put it onto here. So uploading. We'll do a scoped lock, actually. And place back. Basically the data. So it'll be uploading, upload request. No, image upload. Makes a bit more sense. Upload, image upload. I see Clang D is starting to crap out. So it's image upload with P dot. So in these two cases, I need to delete the first of all, I need the information back. Please save it. Thank you. I really like having my editor information. Request. So we're done with it. So I need the M graphics upload context. Either do give the upload request. Put that there. So this is where we do this stuff. Old data equals of P image data. Move the new data in. P image data write lock. I need to scope that up. Okay, this also means I need to slightly rethink how I'm doing like the transition, the resource load state transitions. Because this is now stretching over long, long periods of time. Not exactly what I'm looking for, or looking at, or wanting. Great. Great, 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 great. Okay, one thing though, this goes into the failed state. Failed. For whatever reason, I don't know. I'll need a log thing here as well. So now we're going to have pretty much the entirety of all the possible cases for resource loading. Simple, quick, and now we're going to have delayed upload process as well. From that, I should be able to derive pretty much all the other resources, I think. Once I get all these to work nicely. We can change it to failed. I no longer have the original state. The unload stuff. Do this. Okay. Bad sneeze. Or failed sneeze. Or attempted sneeze. Yeah, process uploads. So I need the process load requests. I will do inline, so but you can still put it into async at a higher level, but not at this level. What will it do? It will go m upload. Lock it. Unlock, we'll make a copy. So much like this, we're gonna make a freaking copy of the thing. Then we're going to go through them all. So for auto and iterator of uploads. And if they're not complete, then they'll just be re-added to the now unlocked version of this down here. So I think that's a simple enough system. It's not quite too convoluted, and it still allows for racing for enough throughput with multiple threads. I think. Which means it's wrong somehow. But I can dream. Let's upload. Much like for active jobs, we have we'll do this. If we're at the point where we're going to add it, we'll do plus plus this. And if we do this and this, so we can have an active count. So we can also do same thing here. If active jobs, if an active uploads is greater than zero, especially if we're deinitializing. Actually, we should put this down here as well, really. Deinitialize. Okay, there's still a lot of problems. Okay, I'm gonna grab a quick drink. Okay. okay. Yes, yeah, great, it crashed again, thank you. Where are we? This image public has YAML stuff. To include that, to grab that stuff in. That's good. It's not that, it's image name. Which one are we talking about? Missing a reference. Okay. So we'll work our way through this. Image loader, we'll come down here. We'll make sure at least we're grabbing the file name. Just test.png, which is the meme image, which is this one. I need to update for that Verizon. I don't even... this stuff is so new, I don't actually even use it yet. So let's do that. image pool. And we'll probably, we'll add the image stuff to the other side. An image loader. I need the image loader. For the moment, anyways. That's out the way. We don't even need this. Maybe. Technically, images would be part under material. Async task function. What else? We need the graphics. Graphic session, I believe. Make sure that works. Okay, we'll also need to do the same thing on the other side for the initialization around here, which will be, I don't know. Which wouldn't even be here, it'd be like up here. If I'm following the same order, that is. Oh, I don't even actually deinitialize these properly. Do I? I just do these. Then, okay, XR is definitely is just after these guys. And then there's camera pool. So you've got to do around here. We come down. Just about here. So we do it after the graphics specific stuff. So it'll be like here. Move it down here. This is the unloading area. This is the deinitialization. So. Here. So we'll create a faux image. Loader. And I think the name was it? Is what else it bring in? Not there, not there, here. Name then loader. And I called it what? The image. Really? Increment use count. Fragment frag. Just over an hour. Okay. Okay, now we're here. Are we at least reading file name in? Yes, test PNG, which means we got that, which means we'd go through this process. That's obviously not going to happen. Okay, I'm going to take another quick break, grab a drink, have a little walk, and have a little think on what I'm going what I'm about to start here. I'm going to have a look at the old code I have here from, I don't know what, like episode 50-ish or so for the old image resource. And I'll be back. Okay. So, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be creating an empty namespace in the load area for the moment while I figure out something better to do. But the idea is load from file, info image. Kind of. Okay, I need free image dot h. What do I have? Okay, result. Image file. I'm thinking real hard right now. Perhaps. Okay. Start with this. What we're going to do, we're going to load all these things. First of all, we get this file name, which gets the one, two, three, four, five locations. Convert it to that. We're going to need this stuff. The format, the extent, the MIP levels, and the data size. Okay, I think I... Well... Okay, you know what? We'll just kind of put it in line for the moment. Whatever. Damn. I don't like it, but there you go. Gotta do some things like this. No, we don't have this, but we're going to have... Error code equals, what are the error codes I have? Import failed. Just say that for now. So we've got all this stuff. Then we're going to, so after total data size, we need the data, and then we unload the stuff. Second portion is create the resources. So again, this is mostly copying from the other side, from the old. Then we've got the image. I'm not going to start the upload until I've finished creating the view and the sampler as well. Yeah, we need a, if there's an error code. Else if, I need a VK res thing for the moment. It's a bit of an error, but with Vulkan error, which will be VK res. This, then I need to actually delete the stuff here. Or what if I've created this stuff and then I partially start the upload process, then I still need to wait out. What I can do is, oh, okay, yes. I need to wait for that to finish, but what I can do is the data is discarded. Image loader. Okay. Otherwise, actually, I can just, okay, I can do this first. Okay, I need to restart so I can get the Clangdy stuff back. Less save. There we go. Everything's back. Else, discard all the data. We already destroyed the upload request, so we can now just unload this data. Keep jumping around. No target data, discard all data, which means I need. Where is it? Where is it? This stuff. Basically, be the same thing here, it looks like. Of course, I need to remove the hooks to the data first. Otherwise, it's not complete, so we just keep going through. That'll become null pointer. We keep passing it through over and over. This is a bunch of. Staging buffer, why do I need a... yes, I do need a staging buffer. So this is something I'd also have to pass around. The image loader data. What is staging buffer? Is it custom information type? Okay, yeah. Bytes per pixel. So we need to include that. Graphics upload. So M total data size is in there. Okay, I need some graphics stuff here. Upload context. Nope, I don't have that. Really? Session. Where is that from? I don't even have this yet. Really? This must be something I've added. Okay. Okay, do I even have that here with me? Graphics PK, I don't have it for upload context, but I do have it from session. So I can get it from this instead. hit the device. Same thing here. Okay. So we do all this, then we have the upload process. So I need to, what's this? Map the data in, record these parts right here. Map the data in through this. Okay. Copy regions is, where is this from? Okay, so if we're here, we gotta go to this point. Okay, we can do this. If Vkeres, then we do that. Then we leave. Then we come back in to error code. So we don't need this case specifically. To go to that, we decrement that. Then we go, okay, if not equal, null handle, then we need to go through the upload process. Otherwise, we can go through this rather verbose deletion thing right here instead. That actually, yeah, I need to pass along the graphics upload buffer as well now. So, oh, I already have it here. I need to pass it through the function. Like that. Gimme. Too few calls to this, thank you. I don't have free image with me quite right now. How did I bring that in here? I don't see where I brought it in. Where did I? Come on, come on, come on. Where did I bring it in from? It's not from there, not from there, not from there. Oh, did I pass it directly to the end one? Yeah, I did. Okay. So for the second, for FR, I'll just pass that in. Make sure we're actually getting stuff to happen. Okay, let's see what happens. What's going to blow apart at the seams here today? Run it, run it, run it. So got validation on, looks like. So we're going to grab it to PNG. We're going to do all this stuff. We're going to get all the data out. That's great. We come to this point. Okay. We do that, then we come out here. First of all, if not error code. And that. If there's already an error code, we'll just go with that one instead. For the moment, because this is whatever. I don't have, I'm not calling in the process loading. So I'll have to come back for that. No error, so active upload, we're going to do this. For the moment is actually probably going to say it's actually complete because I paused in the debugger, so it didn't take very long at all. So in this case, he's got the old data, which is nothing. Let's move this data in there. So this time that'll be fine. I mean, I still have these things to destroy. I guess I don't have an unload. The unload function isn't actually being called. Or, no, I'm pretty sure I have it. Just requesting unload for all of them. Doesn't seem like it's actually destroying stuff. It's got stuff. I'm sorry, what? Okay, does image loader, unload request lists have anything anywhere? No. Yes. Nothing. Okay, does he currently have, he has uploading data? No. Interesting. Okay. Process load requests. Let's go to in the application where we have process the unloading requests. It'll be here. I want to see if this actually comes here at all. Because I don't think the upload will be that fast. Right? There we go. What am I not destroying then? Image, image view, and the sampler. So I'm. And I'm presuming that these are the images. If I come back to here, let's just grab one of them. Okay, let's try it again. Come on, you're really that fast? Are you kidding me? Okay, fine. Oh, okay. Fine. We'll go until it's complete. Then we'll see exactly what the data is. Okay, what was I doing? PM the data, the data, the data, the data. The data I have is what? Let's say the view. It's 228 and 228. Fantastic. Go, 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 go. And then down here, we've got image view. 228 and 228. Yeah, they're not being destroyed. Okay. Let's see about this. Is it... because the use count is still greater than one. Yeah, dumbass. It's my own fault. Of course it is. That's why. Come on. Oh, of course it's there. Now it cleans up. Improvements. Okay, I'm thinking maybe I will commit what I have here at the moment, and then I'll iterate on it. What's it? An hour 40? I'm starting to space out from all of this, so yeah. I'll commit portions of what I have. I mean, what do I have? What's in the log? The temp is the other YAML file, so... Image. Okay. Stage that. Stage one empty line goes with it. Stage these parts. Was So that was okay. We do that. Okay, now we add the image stuff again, which includes this stuff again. Stage that. Stage this. Add that. This stuff. Is properly split. Okay, I'll call it there. Cheers.